Andre Kostelanetz and his music Millions Love. Our guest this evening, Miss Lily Pons. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Alexander Scott speaking for Andre Kostelanetz and for Lily Pons. America's first family of music sends greetings and best wishes to you and your own family, wherever you may be. Wherever our music reaches you now, through the familiar magic of microphone and modulated wave. Tonight's procession of melody begins at once with Fritz Kreisler's Stars in My Eyes. Personals column of our own weekly gazette. Miss Lily Pons of Silver Mine, Connecticut, returned last week via transatlantic clipper after several concert and opera appearances in Paris, France. Welcome home, say we. Her first song with Andre Kostelanetz tonight looks back across the Atlantic to April in Paris.
Holiday stables under the
Our Department of Research and Statistics tells us that shimmering, suave, and imaginative are the three adjectives most frequently applied to the music of Andrei Kostelanetz and the public prints. We're usually careful with our adjectives on the air, but we'll toss in all three favorites to describe this imaginative, suave, shimmering Kostelanetz version of I'm Always Chasing Rainbows. In our house, when I was very young, we had a music box that was also an alarm clock. I was very fond of the little clock and its nameless tune, but after a while, its works wore out, and its successor, a conventional racket maker, was no friend of mine. I can't recall the tune the old clock played, but I'm sure the music it made was very like the song we hear now. Lily Pons, Andrei Kostelanetz, The Music Box by Lyadov, as arranged by Alexander Aslanov.
Charmante, montre-nous les choses à
folk dances of Romania are rugged and wild, resembling the temperament of the Carpathian mountaineer who dearly loves to let himself go of an evening when the last goat is milked and the moon comes over the Balkans. A set of Romanian dances found by Andrei Kostelanetz on his wartime journey provides now a breathlessly acrobatic interlude for the Kostelanetz strings and a listening adventure for all of us. authors have always been fond of the legend about the doll who comes to life, usually on the stroke of midnight, and dances in the moonlight on the toy shop shelf, surrounded by amorous toy soldiers. A famous musical version of the tale has been made into a song for Lily Pons by Frank LaForge. Andre Kostelanetz presents Miss Pons singing Poldini's Dancing Doll. Miss Lily Pons. The high point of her stay abroad was a visit from the President of France backstage at the Paris Opera after a brilliant benefit concert for the widows and wounded of General Leclerc's armored division. In a margin of her concert program, the French leader wrote in part, "To a great artist, the homage of a compatriot, Félix Gouin." At the opera, Miss Pons sang Lakme. We hear now the familiar bell song from that work with Andre Kostelanetz conducting.
Radio Service.